गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ पल्स एंड डिजिटल सर्किट्स। सो इन यस्टरडेज क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट योर क्लिपिंग एंड बिफोर दैट वन वी हैव सीन अबाउट द क्लिपिंग विद इंडिपेंडेंट लेवल्स और टू लेवल्स विद इंडिपेंडेंट लेवल्स। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट द क्लिपिंग विच इज डन बाई टू इंडिपेंडेंट लेवल्स। So two level clipping we have seen, and along with that one we have seen some of the different circuits and the transfer characteristics, how you will be getting the equations and the transfer characteristics, and along with that one we have also seen the how clipping part is done. So what we have said all over summary is that by using this two level clipping we can also use the this particular circuit where you are using two diodes that can be used to generate your square wave. Yes, so if you are applying input as a sinusoidal wave, then by using these two independent level of clipping you can obviously get a square wave. Yes, symmetrical square wave that we have seen in yesterday's class. So in today's class we are going to start our next topic, that is your transistor clippers. So before we move on to the transistor clippers, so these were the circuits that we have seen. So by seeing this one, we can say that this two level clipping can be used to generate your or to obtain your square waves. So with the reference level or above or below the reference level or the breakdown point, how we have obtained this one and where at which particular point we will be getting this transmission region, how your diodes will be working, and when at which particular point you will be getting your inputs and outputs, that we have seen yesterday, right? So here now in the next topic that we are going to discuss is about your transistor clippers. Till now what we have seen, ma, a nonlinear device which is used for your clipping purpose, that is nothing but your diode. Okay, because diode exhibits a nonlinearity, so because it will be working as an on and off condition, so that's the reason we have said that it is a nonlinear device and that is used for your clipping purpose. Now we are seeing that we are using a transistor for your clipping instead of your diode. Now we are going to use a transistor. So how this transistor will be pronounced, or we can also say that how this transistor can be used as a non-linear device. Okay, non-linearity device. How you are going to achieve this clipping by using your transistor, and how it is going to act as a non-linear device. So one which occurs when transistor, when it is crossing its cut-in region into the active region, and second you will be having this you will be occurring this nonlinearity when the transistor is crossing the active region and it is moving into the saturation region. So there will be a particular peak to peak value in the input waveforms, and they, when they are moving from this boundary conditions, like then they are moving from cutting region to the active region, or it is crossing the boundary of your active region and then moving on to the saturation region, at that particular points of that particular portion the input waveform can be clipped off. So by using these regions or these boundaries, we can say that this transistor can also be used as your clippers. Fine, ma. So I'll explain it once again. See, till now we have seen that clippers that were used by using your diodes. Okay, so because diodes can be easily used, they will be on condition or off condition, so they exhibit the non-linearity, then easily we can do clipping above the reference levels and below the reference level when diode is on and diode is off. Easily we have got how we are going to do clipping. But when comes to the transistor, we don't we are not having any on and off condition in your transistor, but instead of that one we are having three different regions in your transistor, that is your cut-in region, active region, as well as in saturation region. So whenever your boundaries are crossing, or your voltage level, input voltage level is crossing, or it is moving from cutting region to the active region, that is one part. Okay, then second part is when your voltage is crossing from the active region into the saturation region, that is one more part. So in that particular point you will be having some peak to peak value of your input waveforms, whatever your input you are applying. For example, I consider sinusoidal wave. If you are applying that input waveform, you will be getting some peak to peak value over there. So this in such way it can be carry the transistor across that boundaries between your cut-in region and active region. Then one more boundary or one more part you will be getting across your active region as well as your saturation region. So in that particular points your input waveform can be clipped off. So that's the reason we can say that this transistor clippers can be used, or your transistor can also be used in your clipper circuits. Fine, ma'am. Normally, it is required that the portion of the input waveform which it keeps the transistor in the active region shall appear at the output without any distortion. So, wherever the circuit, I'll just highlight this particular part, which is very important note for you people in the transistor clippers. So, normally, it is required the portion of the input waveform which keeps the transistor in the active region, means your transistor is active in that particular region. So, that region can be appeared as an output without any distortions. In that case, it is required that the input current rather than the input voltage can be the waveform of the signal of interest. But at that particular point where you want to transmit that particular input signal, so we are using that point as your signal of interest. So, that's the reason. The requirement is that over a large signal excursions in the active region, the transistor output current responds nominally linearly to the input current, but it is related to the quite non-linear manner to the input value. So in transistors, clippers, a current drive needs to be used. So we require a current driver which is used in your transistors, because whenever you are applying, what we are saying here that whenever the large signal is applied in the active region, the transistor current or the transistor output current responds to the linearity. But we require a non-linear device, a non-linear output. So the input current, it will be acting in a linear manner with respect to your linear input current. So it is very difficult to get you a non-linear manner output. So that's the reason we require a clipper current drive or a driver which can be used in your transistor clippers. So the transistor clipper circuit, how it will be appearing, I'll show you. This is your transistor clipper. Okay, so you will be using a resistor over here, okay, which shows your signal source impedance, or a resistor deliberately introduced that must be large compared with your input resistance. It's so this particular resistor should be large, and the transistor, if you are applying this is an input large resistance, then we can say that the transistor will be running in your active region. So under these circumstances, the input base current, your input base current will be very nearly have a waveform of input output voltage, because the base current is given in terms of IB is equals to V input minus your output voltage divided by R. I is equals to V by R, but your VR is nothing but your V output voltage will be is equals to input voltage minus your reference base to emitter voltage. This is VR, this is your base to emitter voltage, and the cut-in voltage that should be greater than of 0.1 volts for your germanium, and this comes to this base to emitter voltage should be less than or approximately equals to 0.5 volts for the silicon. Fine. So I hope you are clear, but anyhow I'll once again explain you. This is the circuit of your transistor clipper where you are having one transistor, and this resistor is followed up by a transistor. So these particular resistor value should be large when compared to the input resistance of your transistor to work this transistor in the active region. So your resistor here should be of your larger value. So under these circumstances, your input base current will be nearly having the waveform of your input voltage only. It means that whatever what is the condition, ma, this should be large. So your transistor will be in the working condition or in the active region, and along with that one, your current of your base current is also larger. So that's the reason you will be getting output as your base current, because the base current is given by I is equals to V by R. What is the V value that you are getting here? V is your input voltage minus your base to emitter voltage. This is base, collector and emitter. So base to emitter voltage, this is the cut-in voltage, so it should be subtracted. So input voltage minus your base to emitter voltage divided by the resistor value. This is the resistor value that you are considering. And for the different materials, we will be using different kinds of values. If I consider for the germanium material, then your base to current value, base to emitter value should be of 0.1 volts. And when I am considering the silicon, then it should be approximately equals to 0.5 volts of your base to emitter voltage. Okay. Now, if the ramp, now I am considering the input signal what I am applying. I am applying now an ramp input signal. Here I am not applying any kind of sinusoid. Fine. So, if an ramp input signal is applied VI, which starts at the voltage below the cutoff and the carry and carries the transistor into the saturation is applied. So, the base voltage, the base current and the collector current waveforms of this transistor clipper will be similarly like this. So what I am applying, I am applying a ramp input voltage, and that ramp input voltage is below of your cutoff voltage. So I am applying here the ramp input voltage, this is your cutoff voltage. So where you are applying the ramp input, it is less than that of your cutoff voltage. Suppose my cutoff voltage is at -0.1 volts, so what applying, I am applying a ramp voltage which is less than that of your cutoff voltage. So it is starting at below the cutoff voltage, so it is starting from here. So I am taking from here, correct? And it carries the transistor into the saturation region. It is starting below the cutoff and it is carrying this region into the saturation region and applied to the base voltage. It is applied to the base voltage and base current and it is moving on to the saturation region. Okay? So it is crossing the cut-in. After that it also reaches the saturation region. So this is the type of what we can say waveform where your voltage which results in ramp input which is driving the transistor of your cutoff region into the saturation region, and it is showing your base. This one shows you the base and collector currents. Okay, this is the time. This shows your base current as well as the collector. This is your base current. Okay, this is your collector current. Okay, from here. And it is moving to the saturation region. After this point, it is moving to the saturation region. And it, from where your input ramp voltage is starting from below than that of your cutoff region. Then it is slightly increasing and linearly increasing and it is moving on to the saturation region. Okay, this is how waveforms of a transistor clipper when you are applying which input, ma? Ramp input as an input, ramp signal as an input signal to your transistor clipper. So the waveform which results when a sinusoidal voltage is applied, here it carries the transistor from the cutoff to the saturation region. So when I am applying this, which first we have applied a ramp signal and we have seen the output waveforms for that one. Now I am applying here, see, ma, we are applying a sinusoidal input voltage as an input. Okay, now to this circuit I am applying a sinusoidal input, sinusoidal wave as an input. So what is the what are the different waveforms that I'll be getting? So what happens here, it is also taking your transistor from cutoff region to the saturation region, from here cutoff region to the saturation region. So the base circuit is biased so that the cut-in occurs when the VBE reaches the voltage V. Okay, whenever the base to emitter collect voltage. So this base to emitter voltage is reaching your voltage, approximate breakdown voltage. So we are saying that at that particular point, you will be having the cutting will be occurring when your VBE reaches the voltage V. Okay, so this is the VBE and this is your reference voltage VBE, capital V. So whenever your base current is biased or clipped, when it is having VBE reaching the value of V. So your VBE is reaching over here. So that's the reason we can say that this particular part can be clipped off. Okay. See here, this is the sinusoidal input voltage and this is your current characteristic that you have got the current. So this particular part is clipped out over here when you are applying the sinusoidal input voltage. Okay, this is the output voltage that you are getting here. And input wave, see the waveforms, first one is a transistor clipper of the figure, and input voltage and the base to emitter voltage. This is the input voltage and this is the base to emitter voltage, correct? This one, this particular part. And when comes to the third one, B, second part, this one B is showing you the base current. This current is showing you the base current over here. Third one shows you the collector current. If you are, I'm getting the collector current, if I'm considering, so your collector current is reaching up to here itself. So this particular part will be clipped off when you are applying the sinusoidal wave as an input. Then third one shows the output that we have obtained. If I reverse this one, so what? This is how we will be getting the output waveform. So this one shows your output voltage. Okay, clear? So this was about your transistor clipper when you are applying the
how many inputs? Ramp input as an input volt signal, or ramp signal as an input, as well as the sinusoidal signal as an input. Okay, I hope you are clear with this topic. Next, move on to the next topic that we are having here, that is your comparators. The name itself shows what is a comparator, ma. What does it mean by comparator? What does it mean? Comparator means you have to compare two things, right? We have to compare. You are comparing something. You are going to compare over here, correct? Here we are using a comparator circuit. Fine. Let's see what the comparator circuit means. So we'll start this topic, comparator. So comparator is a circuit which can be used to mark the instant when what we can say arbitrary waveforms attain some particular reference level. So here it means that it is used whenever you are having a particular waveform and you are going to compare that particular waveform with some particular reference level. So here the nonlinear circuits which can be used to perform these particular operation for clipping may also be used to perform the operation of comparison. So whatever the circuit we have considered for preparation for clipping, that particular circuit only can be used for your comparison. So you can use that particular circuit. We have used independent level of diode, independent level of clippers, where you have diode, we have used diodes also. So that particular circuit can also be used for the comparators also. So in fact, the clipping circuit becomes the element of a comparator system, and that can be usually referred as comparator. So we can also say that the clipper circuit can also be called as your comparator circuit, because clipping circuit become element of an comparator. Okay, we compare that. Suppose I am having two signals, I'll compare in that one. I'll take the one which is having less distortions, or else I can take that one, right? So this is about comparator. When comes to the clipper, when I am comparing to the two circuit, to input waveform, where it is below or above the reference level, then I'll clip off. So they both are similar. Either comparing that one and taking one, or by checking the proper one with less distortions, or removing the distortions and getting the output. So for that reason, we can say that the clipping circuit becomes the element of a comparator, and simply we can refer this as an comparator also. Okay, so the distinction between, or the difference between the comparator circuit and the clipping circuit, is that in comparator there is no interest in responding any part of the signal waveform, whereas in clipping circuit a part of the signal waveform is needed to be reproduced without any distortion. So this is the comparison, or the difference between your comparator as well as the clipper. But the circuit which we are using, we can use that particular circuit, hardware I am saying, either for clipper or comparator. But there is a difference between your clipper as well as the comparator, is that whenever you are using a comparator circuit, I'll just highlight this particular part, make a note of this one. So the difference between this comparator and the clipper circuit is that a comparator, there is no interest in responding any part of the signal waveform, because we are comparing any of the signals and we are taking the best one. So there is no interest of responding to any particular waveform, above the reference level or below the reference level. There is no particular interest of any particular part. Whereas in clipping circuit, a part of the signal waveform has to be needed, and that particular part has to be reproduced without any distortions. See, if I consider this as a clipper circuit, so this much part is clipped off and you have to reproduce this particular part without any distortions. So here the signal waveform should be reproducing. In this part there is no interest in reproducing. We are just comparing and taking the best. Here we have to clip off. It means you have to remove the distortions and you have to reproduce the signal waveform without any noise or errors or any distortions. So that is a bit difference between your clipper as well as your comparator. Fine. So here I am taking a normal diode comparator, the diode clipper which we have seen very first. See this one. So I am considering a diode comparator. So whenever I am applying the input voltage V, which is less than the reference voltage, the diode is on. This we have seen last in the last class itself, when you are seeing the series clippers, correct ma? series and shunt clippers, we have seen that one. So whenever I am applying an input voltage V which is less than the dot of your reference voltage VR, and then at that particular point your diode is in on condition and the output is your VR, because it is your closed circuit, your it will be in the open circuit, so this particular reference voltage will be given as your output. So your output is fixed and that can be given as VR. Now I am applying the input voltage VI which is greater than that of your reference voltage, then your diode will be off, then you will be having a short circuit, then it will be moving on. So your output voltage V0 will be equals to input VI. Correct? Is this correct, ma? So I hope now you people are clear how you are using this clipper circuit for the comparator itself. So here the break will be occurring when your input voltage VI is equals to VR, and when the time is t is equals to ti or t1. So this circuit can be used to mark the instant at which the input voltage reaches at a particular reference voltage. So I can say that this particular circuit can be used to move at a particular reference point. Now comparator may be non-regenerative or regenerative. That can be used. Comparator may be regenerative, it can be reproducing, or it is not necessary, it won't reproduce also. So clipping circuit falls in the category of non-regenerative comparators because you are not regenerating, and in regenerative comparators positive feedback is employed to obtain an infinite forward gain, and that is particularly unity loop gain. So a Schmitt trigger and the blocking oscillator are the examples of your regenerative comparators. Regenerative comparators means you have to compare and you have to regenerate, and these clippers will be falling into the category of non-regenerative comparators because in clipping they are not regenerating the exact output, they will be clipping off, they are removing the distortions or the error. So this clipping circuit may fall into the category of non-regenerative comparators. What does it mean? These comparators are of two categories. One is your regenerative and non-regenerative comparators. So clipping was falling under your non-regenerative comparators, and in regenerative comparators you will be having Schmitt triggers or the blocking oscillators are the best examples for your regenerative comparators. So in Schmitt trigger comparator, it will be generating the approximate step input voltage which we have applied, and this blocking oscillator comparator will be generating a pulse rather than of that of your step output waveform. So when most of the applications of your comparator make use of step or pulse natures of input waveforms which we require as per the particular application where we are using these comparators, right? So these operational amplifiers and the tunnel diodes can also be used as your comparators. So these are also can be used as your comparators. So these are the transfer characteristic of your comparator, how it will be having its particular slope you are having. This is a transmission region and this is one more slope where we are having two comparators. I have said this is the non-regenerative comparators means the clipper, and this is regenerative comparators that can be used for Schmitt triggers as well as the oscillators. Fine, ma'am. So some I have listed here some of the application of your voltage comparators that can be used for your accurate time measurements. Okay, by the name itself, just you have to assume comparators and their applications. Comparators, we have said, they are used for accurate time measurements. If I use two devices of different times for having the proper accurate timing of measuring of that particular accurate timing, I can go for the comparators. Fine. So voltage comparators can be used as used in the particular applications like accurate time measurements. They can be used in pulse time modulations. In pulse time modulations that we'll see in the next year, next academic year, like how your modulation and all will be done. So in this pulse time modulation, that is again categorized into pulse width modulation and pulse position modulation, how they will used. So for that particular purpose also we are going, you are using this comparators. Now comes to the third one, you are having, they can be used in the timing markets generator for a sine wave, as a timing markers generator for your sine wave for a particular time, how much sine wave or a signal can be moved or they can be obtained. and in next one they can be also used in phase meters. They can also be used in amplitude distortion or analyzers, distribution analyzer, amplitude distribution analyzers. They can be used to obtain the square wave from a sine wave, correct or not? Because these clippers can also be used to generate a square wave when you are applying the input as a sine wave. I repeat it once again, this point we have discussed in the last class itself. Whenever we are applying a sine wave to the clipper, this can also be used to generate a square wave. So because the clipper is a comparator, is also a part or type of your what you can say clipper. So in that we can also say that this comparator can also be used to produce a square wave output when you are applying sine wave as an input. And lastly, when you can say that it is used to used in also as analog to digital converters. Okay, so when you see in the next year or the next in the communication subjects where you are going to see the pulse time modulation, there we also see how we are going to convert analog to digital converters, and in that particular point we are using these voltage comparators. Fine ma? So I hope you are clear with this topics that we have discussed today, that is your comparators as well as your transistor clippers. Okay, I hope you are all clear with these topics, and I really hope that students are maintaining notes also. So it's my request students to please to maintain the notes, listen to the classes. Okay, in case of any doubts ma, please do let me know. Fine, give the attendance also, which is very important for your people. Okay, I'll wind up the class here itself. In case of any doubts, do let me know. Thank you.